Hello, yes, is UKIP in safe hands? The leadership race for the leadership of UKIP has just finished. The lead has been announced, it's a Henry Bolton, never heard of him, I'll get back to him in a minute. Anne-Marie Waters, the spy that was sent in there to take over UKIP and lead it down a Tommy Robinson style road of violent confrontation with Muslim, she came second. She was the most obvious spy. It doesn't mean that she was the only one, trust me. But getting back to Henry Bolton, on paper, his CV is excellent. He'd be the type of person you'd want to lead anything. However, being in this game, the amount of time I have and knowing the machinations of the secret state, he's perfect for one of their agents, one of their spies. He's part of the old boy network. He's a former soldier, last job for Queen and Country, like so many before in British nationalism that have been spies for the government, have also been ex-servicemen. By no means am I saying all ex-servicemen spies for the government. What I'm saying is that most of the spies in the movement have been ex-servicemen, right? Anyway, he's an ex-servicemen, also an ex-policeman as well. OBE, Order of the British Empire, trained at the Military Academy of Sandhurst, City and Guilds of London Institute, Christ. You couldn't get more qualified for being part of the old boy network and the system, the powers that be, the elite as they call them. He's part of it. He's a former Liberal Democrat as well. Strange, isn't it? But anyway, don't rule it out. He's one. Now, sorry, Mr. Bolton, if you're not, but, you know, I'm sorry for having a suspicious mind, because I'm normally right, because all your qualifications fit perfectly like a glove. Anne-Marie Waters was obvious to those that have been around a while, what she was up to. She wanted to get in there, take control and lead it down a dead-end road of violent confrontation with Muslim. A personalised war with Muslim, which Tommy Robinson's waging now at the moment. And there's a reason for it, right? Tommy Robinson's book signing in Manchester the 3rd of November. What will that achieve? He's selling his book, Why Muslims Kill for Islam, is it? Who cares? How Muhammad was a nasty paedophile, the horrible man. Again, who cares outside of Islam? We don't. The British people don't. They don't care, right? So what Tommy Robinson has been doing, and Anne-Marie Waters and Paul Gold and Britain First, they've been waging this personalised war against Muslims and Islam. And I'm sure if it goes bang one day and the ghettos go up in Bradford and everywhere else again, like they did in 201, the government would welcome that, because it then gives the government an excuse to bring out more public order laws, hate speech laws, to curtail any real freedom of speech regarding any discussion on mass immigration and Islam in particular. So, and that was Anne-Marie Waters' job, had she taken over, but she didn't, right? She didn't. Henry Bolton, I mean, I don't know. He fits everything, doesn't he? Presses every bone to be part of the old boy network. And I'm sure the old boy network's got contacts in the security services, MI5. I don't know, we shall see. That's all we can do is wait and see. But don't believe Anne-Marie Waters was the only spy contesting the for leadership of UKIP. Trust me, she won't be, right? There'll be a few of them there. You see, the powers that be, right, they're not letting UKIP or British nationalism before it was taken over by the enemy. Another ex-serviceman, that's right, Adam Walker, before he took over the BNP. The powers that be are not letting UKIP populism or British nationalism take power from them, because they know what's going to happen. They're going to be made accountable then for the crimes against this country and its people. They know what's coming. So they're going to pull out the hat, all the old boy network, naked, obvious spies that way for criminal outfits like Nick Lowe's Hope Not Hate, Jerry Gable's Tasteland magazine, like Tommy Robinson, Anne-Marie Waters, Paul Golding and Collett and all the rest of them, Adam Walker, whatever. They're going to pull out all they can. They won't stop at nothing. They will do anything underhanded to stop us. So don't you wet behind the ears, UKIPers, believe I'm talking nonsense. I'm not. I'm normally right. Henry Bolton is just too good to be true, isn't he? And he's part of the old boy network, part of the elite, part of the powers that be, the establishment, whatever you want to call it. But only time will tell. But don't believe, because Anne-Marie Waters was defeated. She was the only spy contestant for the leadership of UKIP. Trust me, I'll guarantee she wasn't. Okay, thank you.